The Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, has congratulated the Uganda Women Parliament Association on passing gender-related bills. UWOPA celebrated a bumper harvest after securing three gender-related bills in a space of just 1 month. They say it was not easy to get the support from their male counterparts. We have on this report.
There are certain things we need to accomplish, especially by way of legislation. And I'm glad that majorly, other than one, the rest have been done. So I really want to thank the members for that.
She was speaking during the award ceremony at Parliament, where the Uganda Women Parliamentary Association celebrated members for their role in passing bills that protect women. The Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, said some government officials tried hard to impede the Sexual Offences Bill and the Succession Bill. She wondered why ministers frustrate gender-related bills, yet they are moved in good spirit to shield vulnerable people in society.
The minister in charge of the sector called me and said, I'm requesting you, we don't proceed on this bill. Government is about to bring their own bill. I said, Minister, I said, can you count how many days we have to the end of the parliament? Do you want me to believe that in 3 days you are going to have a bill here? So I said, I'm sorry, we are moving with this bill. If it is passed, you will come and amend.
Kadaga hailed the UWOPA leadership for their strong stand, even when the executive wanted to stop the process.
When they saw that the women, the UWOPA had moved, now government also brought a bill. So the work now, parliament was now to merge the two bills, remove this, put that, and so on. So I really want to thank you so much for the work you've done. And thank also Honorable Kunihira for the employment bill. Thank you so much.
The Succession Amendment Bill was moved by the Mbarara District Woman MP, Rosette Kajungu Mutambi, the Employment Amendment Bill by Workers MP Agnes Kunihira, while the Sexual Offences Bill, which was passed earlier this week, was championed by Kumi District Woman MP Monica Amoding. UWOPA Chairperson Pamela Kamugo said it was a struggle to court male MPs and journalists to support the bills.
When my colleague moved the Succession Amendment Bill, the government also brought its own, and you were like, what is all this? The good thing that I want to appreciate about government, they sat down, they harmonized, they consulted the stakeholders, and everything was now okay. So we are now waiting for the president to assent on it. Yes. Also, it has not been easy to convince some of our male colleagues on some of these gender bills.
The female MPs of the 10th Parliament are, however, unhappy with not being able to pass the marriage and divorce bill, which has been in the corridors of Parliament for decades. When it was resurrected this year, the Attorney General asked for more time to review some sections.
If we still had time ahead, we would have gone on to even maybe legislate on the marriage and divorce bill. But because of the time and the tight schedules, and yet we still have the budget, I think we've not been able to tackle that. Therefore, we forwarded that one to the 11th Parliament. I want really to congratulate all the members. I want to thank all our male colleagues who have supported us, who have moved with us.
Members of the civil society who attended the event are concerned about the poor implementation of the good laws passed by Parliament. They called for efficiency from the side of government.
In terms of moving forward, we need to know that this is the time when we need each other the most. We truly need each other the most, because implementation of the laws has been our biggest problem. We always make good laws and they stay on paper. Now, in terms of moving forward, let's commit to take it forward so we don't disappoint the very good work that has happened. So we need a shared agenda, and I believe very much commitment is still within. And on the part of civil society and the feminist movement, we are in it together.
As we celebrate today, we remind ourselves of what lies ahead of us. The implementation of the various laws, even those that were passed before 2016, 2021, are still wanting. We still have a lot of resource gaps, particularly in the allocation of resources to the implementation of these laws. The enhancement of our effectiveness and coordination amongst women's organizations and members of parliament, local councillors, still.
4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Thank you very much.